दिस क्लास वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द सर्कुलर मोशन. कंसिडर ए पार्टिकल मूविंग अलॉन्ग ए सर्किल. कंसिडर ए पार्टिकल मूविंग अलॉन्ग ए सर्किल एंड टू पॉइंट्स आई एम कंसिडरिंग हियर. फर्स्ट द पार्टिकल इज एट ए, आफ्टर सम टाइम इट इज एट पॉइंट बी एंड दिस इज द सेंटर O. This is the center O and this is the radius R, and at point B this will be the radius. So it moved from point A to point B and it made some displacement, small displacement, so dx, and this is the angle made by the particle while traveling from point A to point B, so that is d theta. And here the particle is moving along a circle with uniform speed. Speed of the particle is uniform and it is moving along a circle. But if you observe here, the direction of velocity is like this, tangent to the circle. So this is the velocity v1 at a point A, and at point B this is the velocity direction of the particle. So this is v2. See, even though the particle is moving with uniform speed, speed is uniform, let us consider that as 5 meter per second. The particle is moving with 5 meter per second speed. But coming to the velocity, the direction of the particle is changing. At point A, this is the direction of velocity, and at point B, this is the direction of velocity. So the direction of velocity of the particle is changing. From point A to point B, it made some small displacement, and this displacement is a linear displacement. We are considering very small part here, so that is dx. So it is making some linear displacement, and this is a velocity vector v1 and this is a velocity vector v2. So the velocity of the particle is changing. So velocity of the particle is changing in the sense the particle is making some acceleration. Change in velocity per unit time is called as acceleration. So the particle exhibits some acceleration. So the acceleration is also a linear acceleration. The acceleration made by the particle is a linear acceleration. If you consider the same situation here, this is the velocity v1 and this is the velocity v2. Here this angle is d theta, so this angle also will be, and as this angle is equal to this angle, this also will be some d theta. And here the direction of velocity is, this is v1 and this is v2, and the change of velocity is in this direction. So this is called as delta v bar, that means change of velocity. So the change of velocity delta v bar equal to v2 minus v1. So the direction of velocity is changing like this, and the change of velocity and velocity of at point A both are perpendicular. So the direction is changing in this way, and here it is having a linear acceleration. We know that the acceleration is equal to change of velocity upon time. Change of velocity upon time taken. So here change of velocity is delta v bar upon time. it is taking some time dt from while traveling from point A to point B, it is taking some time dt. So delta v bar upon dt. So this is acceleration made by the particle, and this acceleration is a linear acceleration. Direction of acceleration, change of velocity direction or acceleration direction is towards the center. See, at V1 the direction changed like this towards the center, and at V2 also the direction changes like this. So the direction of velocity is changing towards the center. That means the acceleration direction is also same. See, change in velocity direction is equal to the acceleration direction. So acceleration direction is also towards the center. So the acceleration direction is towards the center means we call this acceleration as centripetal acceleration. Centripetal acceleration. Why? Because the direction of acceleration is towards the center. So who is responsible here for making the particle to move in circle? Centripetal acceleration is responsible for making the particle to move in circle. Reason is, speed is constant, 5 meter per second. Speed is not changing. The particle is moving with uniform speed. But who is changing here? Velocity is changing. How velocity is changing? Velocity, the variation between the speed and velocity differs at only a direction. So the direction of velocity is changing. This is the direction of V1 and this is the direction of V2. As the direction of velocity is changing, the particle possesses acceleration, and the acceleration direction is towards the center. As the change of velocity is also towards the center, acceleration direction is also towards the center. So we call this acceleration as centripetal acceleration, and this centripetal acceleration is responsible for the particle to move in a circle. If you consider the change of velocity, how the particle is changing its velocity. First, the direction of the particle is this one, V1, and the change of velocity direction is perpendicular to V1. So like this. So V2 direction will be in this way. So this is V2, or change of direction. And next here, this is the change of velocity direction. So if you consider, here it will become like this. This is also V, or consider it as V3. And here the change of velocity direction is perpendicular to this V3, and it will be like this. So here the particle direction will be like this. So if you put on like this, the particle will make a circle. Particle will make a circle. That means at every instant the direction of velocity is changing. So due to the change of this direction of velocity, the particle is making a circle. So there is a centripetal acceleration, and the centripetal acceleration is responsible for the particle to move in circle in this manner. And let us consider two similar triangles here. Here this is one triangle. So this is delta theta. I am naming it as delta theta. It is making some angle delta theta. And this is a small displacement delta x. And this is the radius r. Well, particle moving from this place to this place. This is making a small displacement delta x, and it is making an angle delta theta. And this is the radius of the circle r. And coming to one more triangle, this is delta V, and this is v and this is also v. Here I am taking only speed, so v, v and delta v. And here it is making some angle delta theta. So here I am writing it as delta theta is equal to, here we can write it as delta theta as delta x upon r. In the same way, here this can be written as delta v upon v. Here I am dividing both sides with delta t. So delta x upon delta t into r, that is equal to delta v upon delta t into v. Here delta x by delta t, that means displacement per unit time, is called velocity upon r, and here change in velocity by time is acceleration. So a upon v. Here by these two equations we can write this as acceleration a equal to c. Do cross multiplication, we'll get v square upon r. So this acceleration is centripetal acceleration. So the centripetal acceleration a equal to v square upon r. So this is very famous formula about centripetal acceleration. So when a particle is moving along a circle, who is responsible for the particle to move in circle? Centripetal acceleration is responsible for the particle to move in circle, around the circle. So this is about circular motion and centripetal acceleration.